appear that the present crisis through which the Jamaat is passing is probably the final battle between the forces of Rahman and Shaitan. After that, we hope, inshallah, there will be a state of يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. I have also reasons to feel, I am using the word feel because this is my state of mind, that the present crisis may last from 2 to 2.5 years. Is there anything in the Holy Quran or Ahadith or the prophecies of Al-Masih Ma'ud alayhi salatu wasalam about your present historical safari outside our headquarters?
Now it's too early to say anything about it, because I hope that the fear you're entertaining will not be real fears. That is what I hope. Yet I agree with you that the great victories which you hope would follow, that they would follow anyway. Because we can see already the signs of big change in Pakistan. There are two extremes developing. A polarization is setting, is in the process of setting. It has happened for the first time in the history of Pakistan, that the government was favoring mullah and the masses were favoring Ahmadis. It is a completely new historical phenomenon, a revolutionary phenomenon, which could never be conceived by the acutest pundit of political religious sphere. Nobody could prophesy that such a thing could happen. What happened was, previously, that there were mullahs riding the fury and storm of the masses and also leading them and egging them on, as against the government, which had a sense of justice and fair play. Even when they succumbed, they had that sense of justice and fair play and did not commit themselves to the wrongdoers, with the side of the wrongdoers. Now this time a completely new phenomenon occurred, which is that despite the best efforts of the government, and they are openly taking sides with the enemies of Ahmadiyya and supporting their stupid, absurd, inhuman demands, and trying to stir up hatred against Ahmadis by publishing papers. So nakedly they have come forward that no sane man in the civilized world could ever conceive such a thing to happen. Only recently, Imam Ahmadi in Canada wrote a letter in the press denying everything that was happening. So one of the scholars from the university rebutted him, who is not an Ahmadi. He is a professor of something. And he rebutted him in a beautiful manner. He said, look here, you are denying the facts, yet your language tells me that you are a liar and not the enemies. First of all, they talk of you with the decency and with the in normal language. And you are referring to them as if you are inside, you are burning in hell and agony. So that agony which you are nourishing within you, that tells me that if in outside free world you are behaving like this, how would you be behaving in Pakistan, where you have all the power to do whatever you please? And secondly, this question which you have raised when I was discussing has been mentioned by him. He said, look here, you say no persecution in Pakistan. He said, no civilized man could ever conceive of a government taking sides in a religious issue and for publishing papers against a sect, a citizen, a free citizen of that country. Said this phenomena is inconceivable. Nobody can understand this to happen unless someone has lost total contact with common sense and justice. So, on one hand we observe this, which was never witnessed before. On the other polarization is becoming stronger and more evident, that the masses are turning to the sides of India. They're openly protecting them, they refuse to be excited when they hear the mullahs speak violently against Ahmadiyyat and preach murder and masquerade, arson and drink and these things. They go to the Ahmadi's houses and say, look here, we are going to protect you. If anything happens, we'll be the first. And don't bother. We don't care for the mullah. So much so that somebody wrote to me from Chinnoor that I am surprised what will happen to this world now. The very people who burnt our house in 74 are coming to us and telling us that we extend our protection to you. Nobody can look to you with evil eyes. And we'll be your protector and your friends. And the same letter was received by me a few days ago from Faisalabad, the same subject. A girl had written that our house was burned by some neighbors and we rebuilt it afterwards. And the same neighbors are now the staunchest supporters of Ahmadiyya. And we can't tell bad names to, call bad names to our enemies, but they are free to do that. So they are doing it for our sake. So that sort of thing could never be conceived. Even one year before. So that is the preparation for a big change. And the roots of this phenomena are in a revelation of Hazrat Masih Maud Rasulullah Salaam, which we find immediately after the revelation which pertained to the time of Bhutto and what happened afterwards. Immediately after, there is an Arabic revelation, Yawma Tubaddalu Samawatu Wal Ardu Ghairal Yawma Tubaddalu Samawatu Wal Ardu Ghairal Ardu Ghairal Ardu Ghairal Ardu Ghairal Samawatu nahi hai na? हाँ यौम तबदुल समावात वल अर्ज गैर अल अर्ज ए टाइम वुड कम बट नाउ आई ट्रांसलेट इट इन द वर्ड ऑफ हजरत मसीह मौऊद अलैहिस्सलाम दिस रेवलेशन स्पीक्स ऑफ ए न्यू हेवन एंड ए न्यू अर्थ बट द ट्रांसलेशन इज ऑल्सो ए सॉर्ट ऑफ रेवलेशन इन इटसेल्फ बिकॉज इट हैज नो बेयरिंग विद डायरेक्ट बेयरिंग with the words of the revelation. What Hazrat Masih Maud understood, and that was what was meant of course by this revelation, was this, in his own words, khayalat aur raayein tabdeel kiye jayenge. And if previously people would think so badly of us, then Allah would see to it that people's views and their attitudes regarding Ahmadis will be changed from above, not automatically. The wheel kiye jayenge, tubaddalu. And from earth and samawat, he interpreted that in every direction the change will be witnessed. So that is exactly what is happening in Pakistan. So whether the things worsen still or begin to beat retreat, I don't know as yet. As far as the intentions are concerned, they are very evil. They are finding themselves in a helpless position. They are in fact making repeated appeals to the masses to cooperate with the government to destroy enemies. And the masses are not responding. Rather, the Zafarok had to issue an appeal, public appeal, that what has come of you? What has happened to you? We are ready to destroy and you are not cooperating. Come forward with your support and see what happens. And you don't know what event has taken place, what historic event has taken place. They didn't know, nor did he, because what historic event had taken place in the heavens. And the time had come when Masih Maud Salam's revolution about a change in the attitude and views of the people were to be affected by Allah. And this is the time. So how long this phenomenon is going to take and whether we shall suffer much greater and more heinous persecution at the hands of the government of Pakistan, we don't know as yet. If permitted, they will do it. They will not spare. If permitted, I mean if permitted by Allah. So that is something which neither you can know nor I can know unless Allah tells us. But enemies are ready for every sacrifice. It's my emphasis. They are not afraid. And this is a third difference which is observed from the past anti-MD agitations. A very distinctive feature to be observed in fact. Previously, whenever the mullah went started wide-scale campaign against Ahmadis and started preaching their murder and everything, Ahmadis were gradually cowed down. You could see worries on their faces. There were people who of course would never think of renouncing Ahmadiyya, but they walked with crestfallen heads and they were depressed very much, and many were afraid, and they would send people to Rabwa asking for permission to move from that particular place. There was danger in this and that. And sometimes hundreds of empty houses would request for permission to abandon that place of extreme danger. Now this time, not a single request has been made. Even those families who were completely alone, surrounded entirely by the non-families. If you read their letters, you will be surprised what a big change has happened. They say that we are here and that we are very happy. We are in complete peace and we love these days. Such a days, such spiritual heights which we have gained, could never be dreamt by us before earlier. Even the youngest children are enjoying this. And we are ready for offering anything. Let the enemy come and we are not going to be cowards. This is the spirit of the enemies living in the length and breadth of Pakistan. Everywhere, every province. And it's so surprising. It is for you to go and observe the phenomena to believe how it is taking place and how immensely and deeply it has transformed the lives of enemies. So this is the third phenomena which is different from the past behavior. So very big things are going to happen, I tell you. It is writ large on the horizon. Nobody can change this. Yet, I cannot positively claim when the final victory will come, when I shall be able to return, or whether we shall be murdered in large scale, or deprived our properties, or declared to be banned, or whatever they want to do with us. Anything can happen, if Allah permits that. Because as far as their intentions are concerned, that they are certain. But also one thing is certain, and it is written in the Holy Quran, that if they move forward another few steps, they will be so terribly punished by Allah that lessons will be drawn from them by the outside world. And Allah will repeat it. And I am referring to a surah of the Holy Quran, which is Surah Buruj, and at least once a week I recite it in the morning. in Surah Al-Buruj, Allah Ta'ala tells us of a time, an age of the Ma'ud, the promised one, when things are going to happen. Now it's a long story, to cut it short, I refer you to the study of commentary on this surah by Hazrat Musleh Ma'ud, which he made in 1945 and which was later on published before partition, of course. It has been now published as Tafsir-e-Kabir in Surah Al-Buruj. Whatever began to happen in 1974 has been related as if he is watching all these things to happen by Hazrat Musleh Ma'ud, drawing his influence from this surah. He tells us that this surah is applicable to end of the year, and it tells us of some future events. This and this is going to happen to end of the year, and this time the trial would come to sit, and it will not be a transient trial like the 34 allowment and this and that. And it will be a long trial spread over years. Then if the enemies repeat what they had done earlier, then Allah will begin to punish them. And this is exactly what has been mentioned in the surah. So that means that when the phenomena was to begin, that was in 74, they would be permitted by Allah, according to the prophecy of this surah, to continue in their persecution for a while. And a stalemate was to be brought about after some time. Then the Holy Quran tells us in this surah that if they repeat the same thing, then Allah will begin to punish them. In the meantime, they will be permitted to tarry for a while without punishment. And the words of Allah to which I am referring are these: إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُوا فَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمَ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ الْحَرِيقِ إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ إِنَّهُ هُوَ يُبْدِئُ وَيُعِيدُ وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الْوَدُودُ ذُو الْعَرْشِ الْمَجِيدِ فَعَالٌ لِمَا يُرِيدُ. That if these people who have been torturing my people for no fault of theirs, if they repeat what they have done. Now this repetition means a repetition of some great event, because everything is there according to this surah. They are being persecuted. So that repetition is a constant phenomenon. It is not referring, that phenomenon is not referred to in this verse where the Holy Quran says, if they repeat that, then we would begin to punish them. And we would repeat our punishment. They will not be just punished once, singly, but punishment after punishment will be their lot. Then Allah says, إِنَّهُ هُوَ يُبْدِئُ وَيُعِيدُ. And the same phenomena is described again so beautifully in answer to their behavior. That you began once by declaring somebody non-Muslim and starting behaving in beastly manner to my people, and did not get satisfied at it. Then he repeated the same thing in a different way. He says, إِنَّهُ هُوَ يُبْدِئُ وَيُعِيدُ. Allah also begins, and He also knows how to repeat things. So if He begins to punish you, He will repeat His punishment. So that is the fate of these people if they do not repent, and mend their ways. What I am afraid of is their lot. I assure you, I can see it written before me. I can There is no question of a prophecy about it. It is a decree seen by Allah that if they are not permitted to reform and to mend their ways, they will be either washed onto the face of the earth in a most terrible manner, or some other punishment is going to overtake them. And they will be made a lesson for the rest of the world. So that is what you should be worried about. But again, I hope this will not happen to Pakistan, inshallah. Why? Because the people have changed. And this is also the mercy of Allah, that for the sake of the falling out of you, He does not punish a larger number of innocent people. Although they are not entirely innocent, they are also indulging in every type of crime and defiance of Islam in practical life. Yet, in this regard, they have behaved beautifully. So, because they are mending their ways, therein lies the hope of the future of Pakistan. If Allah permits them to continue, move in the same direction, then Allah would know how to punish the regime, not the people of Pakistan. And He knows how to go about these things. So we only hope and pray to Allah that our brothers in Pakistan, who are behaving so nobly, majority among them, to their enemy brothers, and they are showing the human values in a beautiful manner, they should be saved the punishment, and only the culprits and the very top among them should be punished. Now, azan and then prayer.